Hi everyone, and welcome back to Music Unite. Today we have Martina Corsini, singer-songwriter from Italy, with us in the studio. Thank you so much for being here, Martina.
Thank you for having me.
So, you're only 22 years old. You have released your own stuff, a lot of success. But let me take you back a little bit. So, where did you start making your first steps into music?
So, I guess it was when I was about 12, because it wasn't in primary school. We got something between primary and secondary school that's called media. And I started taking piano lessons there and also a couple of singing lessons, although I was, well, young. But then, yeah, and almost immediately after that, like a couple of years after that, I started composing my own stuff because my father plays guitar as well and taught me how to play guitar. So, yeah, and then I decided to make it my career. So.
So you have been living here in Scotland for about 3 years?
3 years now, yeah.
So you've done many gigs here as well. Do you feel there's a difference playing in front of the Scottish audience?
Compared to the Italian audience?
Yeah.
Not a huge difference, to be honest. It's just, it feels like it's easier to bring people along to gigs here in Scotland because I think it's more rooted in their culture. Like, back in Italy, the music scene is not huge. So I guess it's because of that. But I made like a, so I done like a sort of experiment. I asked several times both to Italians and Scottish audiences if they would rather listen to an original song or a cover, and they both went for the original songs. So I guess it's they're both interested in, you know, supporting emerging acts and stuff like that. But it feels like it's easier to bring people along at gigs here in Scotland.
So of course music plays a very big part to many different cultures.
Yeah.
What role does it play in the Italian culture? Are there any particular traditions that involve music?
So, not that I can think of, not that turns around music, but we've got like tradition in like, I don't know, like festival, traditional festivals and stuff like that, and medieval festivals in some villages in the countryside. And it doesn't turn around music, but involves music because it's part of the culture. So we, I don't know, see like a bunch of like a proper orchestra marching through the village and playing medieval songs. And then I guess we got like one big festival that is called, it's actually went on air a week ago. It's called Festival di Sanremo. And if you ask me, it's not great. Maybe it was decent or good like 50 years ago, a few decades ago. Now it's just not. It's bad, but it's an old tradition. Yeah. Got your time, you wasted it all. Not you want me back, but baby, I'm out on my own. Don't care if you're cold and alone. Hey, 'cause ain't got no time, ain't got no patience. Sorry, if you don't get it, I write it on stone. Too late, I'm out on my own, and I'm all right, I'm all right.
What kind of difficulties do you think artists like yourself are facing in Italy at the moment?
In Italy, so in my own country. Again, the music scene is fairly big here. It's non-existent in back in Rome, where I'm from. And it's kind of sad. And like you would see, like, I think there's no middle ground. Like, either you are a VIP, but if you're an emerging act, you have no chance whatsoever to, you know, to make it your own career. So I think that's the big difficulty.
It's hard to break,
yeah, because I don't want to be in a new Beyonce. I know that I'm never going to be the new Beyonce. And if I just want, you know, to play my gigs and have my audience, it's, like, I don't know, like a couple of names that come to my mind are Dottie Clark or Orla Gartland or Hudson Taylors or even Nina Nesbitt. They're like, you know, fairly famous, but not that much. We don't have that in Italy. Either you're a VIP or you don't play music. Hit me like the sun when it's Sunday morning.
but it's still cold outside. Tell me you're not gone, it's still pretty early. Let's go on a ride. I'll take you to Pacific Coast, California. We can pretend to feel free like I told you. Nothing's true.
So of course music means different things, different people. What does it mean to you? What role does music play in your life?
Oh, a huge one, definitely. Like a huge role. I would say, like I was thinking about this a couple of weeks ago, and it feels like I'm in a romantic relationship with music, because I mean, I love it. I'm in love with it, and I want to play music and listen to music every second of my life. But as in every couple happens, sometimes it feels like it's overwhelming and I need to take a break because I don't know, I'm not inspired and I cannot compose anything and I don't want to listen to music. So I just spend days in complete silence. But during those days, I realize how much I need it and it's part of my life and I want to spend the rest of my life with it.
Okay, yeah.
So yeah, I guess I'm in a relationship with music.
So thank you so much for being here.
Oh, thank you for having me again.
You're not going anywhere?
No.
You're going to perform for us in a second?
Not moving.
Now, we're going to take a little trip to Greece, where Sofia Valasiadou, a mother, a full-time teacher and a singer, shares with us her love for soul and blues, as well as the difficulties she and her band Acoustic Group 36 are facing in a small town in Greece.
Η μουσική είναι θεμελιώδες κομμάτι της ζωής μου, μαζί με το διάβασμα και με τη ζωγραφική. Όταν ήμουνα εφηβή, είχα την τύχη να μπω σε μια παρέα που άκουγε πολύ ωραία μουσική, ροκ μουσική, και έτσι τα ακούσματά μου ήταν αυτά. Πολλούς δίσκους βινιλίου, πηγαίναμε σε συναυλίες, στο ραδιόφωνο, ψάχναμε τις εκπομπές αυτές. Στην πορεία, όταν μόνη μου αναζήτησα κι άλλα μουσικά ερεθίσματα, επειδή διάβαζα πολύ λογοτεχνία της δεκαετίας του 50 και παρακολουθούσα ταινίες film noir, ασπρόμαυρες ταινίες, έμπαινα μέσα σε αυτή την ατμόσφαιρα. Οπότε κατέληξα και στα σημερινά μου ακούσματα που είναι η soul και η blues μουσική. Μου ήταν πάρα πολύ εύκολο να μπω στην ατμόσφαιρα αυτών των τραγουδιών και να ταυτιστώ με τις μαύρες μουσικές, γιατί είχαν αυτό το σκοτεινό κομμάτι, αυτή τη μελαγχολία που μου τέριαζε εμένα σαν ιδιοσυγκρασία. Στην πορεία έκανα μαθήματα μονοδίας, ασχολήθηκα και επαγγελματικά, συνεργάστηκα με αρκετές μπάντες. Ωστόσο, παρόλο που η μουσική, μπορώ να πω, έχει πρωταγωνιστικό ρόλο, δεν την ακολούθησα επαγγελματικά, γιατί οι σπουδές μου ανοίξαν έναν άλλο δρόμο. Σπούδασα ελληνική γραμματεία και φιλοσοφία και βρέθηκα να διδάσκω 25 χρόνια τώρα, στη δευτεροβάθμια εκπαίδευση, να έρχομαι σε επαφή με τους εφήβους και η επαφή αυτή μου έφερε νέα μουσικά ακούσματα. Μεγάλωσα δύο κορίτσια, τα κορίτσια πάλι μου διδάξανε άλλες μουσικές και δεν έπαψε ποτέ η μουσική να είναι ένα πολύ ζωντανό μέρος στη ζωή μου. Τα τελευταία χρόνια δημιουργήθηκε αυτή η μπάντα. Ξεκίνησε έτσι από ένα κοινό μεράκι που έχουμε για τα ακούσματα αυτά, όπως είπα και πριν. Soul, rock, rhythm blues. Στην μπάντα διασκευάζουμε. Δεν δημιουργούμε δικά μας κομμάτια. Διασκευάζουμε πολυδιασκευασμένα τραγούδια. Και αυτό είναι για μένα μαγικό, γιατί στην ουσία είναι σαν να βάζεις κι εσύ ένα μικρό λιθαράκι σε κομμάτια που ακούστηκαν, ερμηνεύτηκαν, αποδόθηκαν από άλλους και γίνεσαι κάπως σαν συνδημιουργός. Η μπάντα αποτελείται από τρία άτομα, αυτός είναι ο πυρήνας Συνεργαζόμαστε κατά καιρούς και με άλλους μουσικούς όταν μπορούμε να βρούμε ένα περιβάλλον, ένα χώρο που να σταθούμε περισσότερα άτομα πάνω στη σκηνή. Εξαιρετικός μουσικός είναι ο Άγγελος που παίζει πιάνο, τρομπέτα και φλικόρνο. Έχουμε κιθάρα και ερμηνεία, εγώ. Τα τραγούδια μας, όπως ναι, σου είπα, είναι διασκευές. Είναι διασκευές αυτής της μουσικής που αγαπάμε. Και είναι αρκετά δύσκολο να βρούμε χώρους για να παίξουμε τη μουσική που αγαπάμε, γιατί στην Ελλάδα είναι μια χώρα που έχει και μια άλλη μουσική κουλτούρα. Είναι περιορισμένη η χώρα, είναι περιορισμένο το κοινό που αγαπάει αυτή τη μουσική που αγαπάμε εμείς. Οι αμοιβές είναι πενιχρές. Ωστόσο, το μεράκι μας και ο ενθουσιασμός μας και το πάθος που έχουμε μας κάνει να μην τα βλέπουμε όλα αυτά. Η μουσική μου προσφέρει αυτή την εσωτερική ένταση, δηλαδή μια πληρότητα, μια έξαψη όταν προετοιμαζόμαστε στις πρόβες, όταν στείλουμε τον ήχο, όταν μελετάμε τα τραγούδια, όταν σκεφτόμαστε πώς θα τα ενορχιστρώσουμε. Μπορώ να το πω κιόλα, με απομακρύνει από την πεζότητα, από την ρουτίνα, έτσι, μιας καθημερινότητας που έχει πάρα πολλές επαγγελματικές και οικογενειακές υποχρεώσεις. Αλλά επίσης, ναι, στα live, στις ζωντανές συναυλίες, είναι η μουσική αυτή που φέρνει την επικοινωνία με ένα άγνωστο πρόσωπο, με τα άγνωστα πρόσωπα, το κοινό, και μικραίνει στην ουσία την απόσταση ανάμεσα σε σένα που είσαι στη σκηνή και σε αυτούς που βγήκαν από το σπίτι τους για να σε ακούσουν, για να μοιραστούν το συναίσθημα που απορρέει από τη μουσική. Για μένα όμως το πιο σημαντικό στο χώρο αυτό είναι η ομάδα, είναι η παρέα. Είναι ότι εμείς οι τρεις βρισκόμαστε πολλές ώρες, με πολύ μεράκι, με πολύ διάθεση, με πολύ όρεξη, κόντρα στις δυσκολίες, στις αντικσοότητες και σε ένα περιβάλλον έτσι στερημένο από ερεθίσματα, και αυτή η ομάδα με συνεπέρνει. Το να βρίσκομαι μαζί με την παρέα μου, να κάνουμε πρόβες, να εμφανιζόμαστε στους χώρους που επιλέγουμε να παίξουμε, το θεωρώ πάρα πάρα πολύ όμορφο και πάρα πολύ δημιουργικό.
Thank you so much for watching today's episode. Be sure to subscribe to our channel and follow us on our social media. All the information about Martina is in the description below. Now, enjoy Martina singing her song Netflix and Chill. Until next time.
Ultima lezione di pazienza, pane, burro, marmellata, colazione. Ce l'hai tu? Preferisco un piatto caldo, le tue mani fredde su di me. Ancora tu? Lo vuoi fare un altro giro, il Tevere Expo? Tanto chiude tardi, ma questo già lo sai. A metà agosto è pieno e non ci vieni mai. Un calice di vino, un'altra sigaretta spenta, che ha smesso di fumare. Mai provato a camminare a piedi scalzi, che le tue scarpe sono più scomode dei sassi. Quanti passi ancora tocca fare, prima di arrivare, prima di arrivare. Non pensare di conoscere il finale, in questa storia il lieto fine va puttane. Tutto bene, credo non c'è male, e mi rilasso sul divano e guardo un po' di Netflix and chill. Netflix and chill. Tu il vento e la foglia, pensavo di volerti scrivere, invece ora non ne ho più voglia. Spiegami perché ogni stanza mi ricorda te il tuo profumo. Non mi ami e se mi ami fai male, ti prego non ridere più. Mi hai spoilerato il finale, sì tanto la stronza sei tu. E poi aspetta, com'era? Dimmi cos'è che ti piace di me. Prendimi e stringimi, rendi felice. Baciami ancora, non dirmi il perché. Tanto domani ritorno da Alice. Principessa, questa volta non ci casco. Se sono rose fioriranno, no. Tanto ho già staccato tutte le spine. Ora mi rilasso sul divano e guardo. guardo Netflix and chill. Netflix and chill. Netflix and chill.